After an exciting barn burner of a girls' game, it's time now for the boys to take over. Lake Orion taking on the F.A.I.T.H. Falcons. We take you now, Greg Bullen and Bill Hetchler at Hunters Creek Community Church. Take it away, guys.
Thanks, Dave. We appreciate that. Well, Bill, it doesn't get much better than that.
No, it was fantastic. I mean, both coaches said that was one of the best games that either team has played this year so far.
Very well matched. Well, we're here for the boys, and we're getting set for the opening announcements and prayer, and we'll see how this game goes. I will tell you this, that having not seen either team yet, just the eye test in warm-ups, the F.A.I.T.H. Falcons look a lot bigger than the Lake Orion Lions.
Yeah, they do, and they're a 3-1, and they've only lost. The only game that they've lost was to a ranked team, so a nationally ranked team. So
right, exactly.
I think they're going to be in good shape tonight.
And we're going to pause for prayer for just a moment. We apologize that you can't hear it better, but we're not going to talk over the prayer. So
no.
Even if you can't hear it very well. And good crowd here tonight. Of course, they got treated to a great girls' game. And hopefully the boys will be just as exciting. Let's pray. Amen. Well, Bill, why don't you give us our starting lineups for tonight?
Okay. Under Coach Rowe, we have the Lake Orion Lions. They're going to start number 3, Scott Streetman. Number 11, Michael Slezak. Number 12, Mason Rowe. Number 14, Ian Brennan. And number 22, Joshua Bryson. Coach Irvin's F.A.I.T.H. Falcons will start number 2, Zach Jewell. Number 10, Colin Blackmer. Number 14, Joel Shepard. Number 24, Devon Kaufman. And number 52, Caleb Nichols.
And introducing the teams now, and they're going to introduce the F.A.I.T.H. Falcons. And they are a big team. Tall guys, and just watching the guys warm up, they were hitting threes pretty well as well. I do want to say that I know there are people listening. We've had several people come up and say that and ask how they can listen online.
Yep.
And of course you can do that at WMPC.org. A lot more people can get us online. They can get us through the air at this time of day.
Yes.
So if you're listening online at WMPC.org, we want to welcome you in. And I know the Heichels are listening. Their grandson Ian Brandon is starting for Lake Orion. And there's a lot of other folks. And, of course, after that game, a lot of people want CDs of the games
as well. Yeah, the girls have already ordered 12 CDs for their team, so that's the way it is.
Well, it should be an exciting game tonight, and we'll be set to tip in just a few minutes. And really, you know, we think of this, because this is our first broadcast, as early in the season, but really it's the fifth or sixth game for a lot of teams.
Yes, it is.
They've been playing since Thanksgiving.
Right. So, in fact, a lot of teams, some teams, the college teams have all gone through a couple of tournaments.
Yeah, absolutely. That's definitely the trend in NCAA. Go to Hawaii or go down to Nassau and play and the NIT has an early season tournament as well at Madison Square Garden.
Must be tough to have to go to Hawaii or Nassau.
Yeah. Well, it's great for some of these kids. They just have never been places like that. Devin Kaufman's going to jump for the F.A.I.T.H. Falcons against Brennan. And it's tipped back, controlled by Lake Orion. Point guard for Lake Orion is Mason Rowe. He drives and dishes, throws to nobody. It's tipped around and controlled by F.A.I.T.H. Colin Blackmer brings it down. Now he dumps it off on the right side. They go far side. First three of the night is up and no good. Long rebound comes out to Jewell. Now Kaufman, he'll take the three from beyond the arc. It's too strong. And rebounded by Josh Bryson and Lake Orion. Still no score. First minute of play in this boys varsity contest. Rowe has it up on top. Dribbles to his right. Gets a screen. Goes hard to the baseline and then dribbles back out. And he lost his dribble. Bodies hit the floor over there, and we've got a held ball, possession arrow to F.A.I.T.H. Jewell will bring it down. Staying over on the left side. Ball comes to Kaufman at the top of the key. He'll put up the shot. It's a little too strong. and rebounded there by Brennan. He went up high and brought it down. Minute gone, no score yet. Rose got it up at top, and we got an offensive foul.
A little push off.
That's going to be against Scott Streetman. He protested a little. Yep. Yeah, that's a long way from the ball, so I have no idea what actually happened. It was under the basket.
I think he pushed off a little bit.
Zach Jewell dribbles down to his right this time. Looks at Coffin on the high post. Now gives it up to Nichols. Nichols goes cross court. Now gets it back up at midcourt. Jewell has it over on this side now as they pass around the horn. Tipped away by Streetman. He wants to go hard up on the left side. Nice soft touch. Puts it up and in. Scott Streetman with the first points for either team with almost 2 minutes gone. 2-0 for Lake Orion. And then a three in the corner by Joel Shepard. 3-2, F.A.I.T.H. Falcons. Rowe dribbles across the timeline. He's guarded by Jewell. Dribbles to his left, dribbles to his right. All this is up near midcourt. Dribbles into the paint, and it's stolen by Blackmer. He's going to go end-to-end, puts it up and in. Colin Blackmer makes it 5-2 for F.A.I.T.H. Coach Tom Rowe wants them to call a play and run it. F.A.I.T.H. Falcons matched up man-to-man, and they're forced to call a timeout as Rowe got trapped up at midcourt over in the corner right in front of the scores table. And he had to call a timeout to avert disaster, I guess, is the best way to put it.
Exactly. Well, the Falcons have definitely shown their superiority height-wise. They were able to, Mr. Blackmer was able to take that thing down and put it up, even in spite of the fact that he had a defender right with him.
Yeah, I was impressed by Streetman, too, when he got the breakaway. Mm-hmm. He went strong to the hole but had a nice soft touch in that left-handed layup. So it's 5-2. F.A.I.T.H. Falcons with the lead. 5:31 to go here in this first quarter. Good crowd here tonight. If you're headed this way, it's still early in the game. You can come get a seat. But most of you, I suspect, are going to stay close to your radio or smartphone or computer, however you're listening to us tonight. Lake Orion will come out with the ball. Now Roll will have it. He's got it in the backcourt. F.A.I.T.H. has dropped back into a 2-1-2, but they're going to slide it. Now they break out of it. And Kaufman has the steal on the tip. Jewell brings it down. Looks over on the far side. Passing quickly. Shepard gives it up to Nichols at the top. It went in and out. Long rebound comes out to Rowe for Lake Orion. Long pass into the paint. Turn, shoot, partially blocked. Kaufman rips down the rebound. Long pass in the corner to Jewell, back to Nichols. Now Kaufman has it. He's going to go hard to the hole, and they're going to call an offensive foul. Brennan set up there and took the contact. Kaufman thinks he's shooting free throws, and he's wrong. Now the refs are, well, he is shooting free throws. He's right. I was wrong. I thought he called an offensive foul, but he didn't. Fouls on Brennan with the block. Kaufman was the only player that knew what was going on. Yeah. His first free throw is too strong, but tipped right back in by Blackmer. Streetman goes hard to the hole right at Kaufman. Kind of dipsy-doos around him, gets his own rebound, puts it up and misses. Brennan with the putback, he misses. Now Kaufman has it. Stepping in and putting it up for the F.A.I.T.H. Falcons. That was Joel Shepard. 11-2 now with 4:16 to go. Streetman with the ball at midcourt, guarded by Jewell. Dribbles to his right. Brennan's got it in the corner. He'll go on the baseline. The J's no good. And the rebound comes out to Blackmer. He brings it down quickly. spins in front of Jewell, goes hard to the hole, now shovels it around. They swing it around to Nichols for the three. He puts it up and in. 14-2, 3:50 to go. F.A.I.T.H. Falcons with the lead. Lake Orion with the ball. Brennan's got it over here on the far side. Dribbles to his right, now picks up his dribble. Cross-court pass is stolen. And Jewell will, or Shepard rather, will stop. Give it up to Blackmer. Jewell comes over to help, and now he'll get it up at the top. Nichol is wide open in the corner. He'll shoot the three and put it in.
They've been not leaving him open all night long. He's money at that distance.
Defense was laying way back on him, and he had plenty of time to shoot. Now Streetman comes around on the right side. F.A.I.T.H. Falcons matched up man-to-man. Bryson goes into the paint and has his pass stolen by Jewell. Everybody's back. Jewell goes to the free throw line. He'll shoot it from there. It's no good. Rebound by Brennan. Lake Orion with the ball. They're down 17-2 with 2:43 to go here in this first quarter. Rowe has it up on top. Jewell now still in the backcourt. And we got a foul. That's going to be an offensive foul and moving screen on Michael Slezak. You got to plant your feet and stay still. Grant Blackmer coming in the game for Lake Orion. They always have to have siblings, don't they?
Oh, yeah.
Just to make it hard on the announcer. Blackmer with the free throw at the free throw line. That was Colin Blackmer. It's lost out of bounds. It's going to stay F.A.I.T.H. ball as it goes out over in the corner. Pass comes in to Colin Blackmer. Pass around. And an easy 2 points for Grant Blackmer on the weak side. 19-2 with 2:10 to go first quarter. Streetman crosses the timeline, goes into the paint, drives hard to the hole. Shot's a little too strong, tips it up, nearly tipped it back in. But that kid can really elevate.
Yeah, he can for his size. He's really up in the air.
Nichols has it on the far side, gives it up to Gleason, who's in the game. Garrett Gleason for F.A.I.T.H. They swing it around to Shepard on this side. Colin Blackmer open in the corner. Shepard instead dishes out to him after driving in the paint. And it's another easy 2 points as the pass came down on the low post to Grant Blackmer from his brother, and he put it up and in.
Jewell just stole it and put it up in.
And Jewell steals the inbounds pass, and just like that, it's 23-2.
Not Jewell, Joel Shepard, I'm sorry.
Joel Shepard with the steal and the putback.
Wow.
Exactly. What else can you say? Well, I got to be honest, I was told this might be a tough game for Lake Orion.
Yeah.
And so far it has been.
Now they've not been able to solve the puzzle of the height and speed of F.A.I.T.H. Falcons.
Well, the good thing is they've been able to get the ball in the paint. They've missed some bunny shots that they should have made.
Right.
And so maybe if those start to drop, they can shorten the gap a little bit. But one of the things that Lake Orion's going to have to do is extend their defense.
Yeah.
They're going to have to extend the defense.
Yeah, they can't let the F.A.I.T.H. Falcons get all the way down inside.
Wow. Scott Streetman brings it across the timeline. Now gets it over to Rowe. Back to Streetman. Tries to go down low to Brennan, and it's tipped away. And then Streetman with the foul.
And that's two on him.
Colin Blackmer had the ball, and Streetman came up and sort of mugged him from behind. Garrett Gleason will take it out.
And Drake Irvin comes in for the Falcons.
Colin Blackmer, yes, and he's going to be a big presence on that low post. He comes out and sets a pick.
When he sets a pick, he sets a pick.
And a long two there by Grant Blackmer is no good. And it's going to be Lake Orion ball on the long rebound out of bounds. Mason Rowe gets it in to Brennan. He gives it back up to Rowe. Starts to slide low post. Now stays up and sets a pick. Rowe goes cross court to Streetman. He's got it up near the center circle. Now over on the right side. 43 seconds to go first quarter. And the pass to Streetman is off his foot from Rowe. And that was Josh Bryson, rather, setting up on the high post, and the pass hit him right on the foot and bounced out of bounds. 38.7 seconds to go, 23-2. F.A.I.T.H. Falcons with the lead. Jewell's got it up on top. Now gives it up to Shepard. Back to Jewell. Gleason on the far side. And the little bunny there is no good. Mason Rowe with the ball. And he double dribbled. We got a foul. Foul on Shepard, I believe. That was Drake Irvin with the miss just a minute ago on the low post. Ball comes in for Lake Orion. Rose got it up on top. Trying to get a pick. 10 seconds to go. Picks up his dribble. Nearly has it stolen. Streetman comes in. Brennan's low post puts it up. Just missed it. Drake Irvin with the rebound. And the long shot from half court just misses. And just like that, the first quarter is over and it's 23-2.
Right. That last pass could have been a touchdown.
Yeah.
Caught it in the end zone.
Yep. So let me ask you this, Bill. Mm-hmm. If you're in the Lake Orion huddle right now and you're their coach, what are you saying to them?
One thing, they're going to have to try to box out down low for one thing, because they don't have the height to be able to rebound with them. And they're going to have to move that ball around just a little bit more. Just a little bit more. I think they're trying to do too much. One person's trying to do too much and needs to pass it off.
Yeah, absolutely. I think the key to getting back in this game is defense.
Right.
I think they're going to have to shut them down. They're going to have to extend the defense a little bit. Maybe set maybe a 2-3, but extend when someone like Nichols sets up for the three-point shot. Kaufman likes the three-point shot. We've seen him try a couple.
Mm-hmm.
And he was certainly hitting those in warm-up as well.
And the Lake Orion's definitely got to, they've got to box out down low. They're looking winded already.
Working hard in this game. Rowe will take it out. He's got Streetman up to help. And Slezak now, he'll drop off to the right side. Streetman looks at him. Slezak sets a pick. Streetman goes around him. Dribbles down into the corner. Tries to force in a bounce pass. And it's a shot there by Brennan. No good. He hit the deck. But Lake Orion controls the rebound. Rowe shoots a three. It's off the side of the rim. No good. Rebounded by Colin Blackmer. Long pass is stolen underneath. And Lake Orion will have the ball. That was Josh Bryson with the steal. Ball's tipped out of bounds. Rowe was trying to go to Brennan in the corner. Knocked out of bounds by Colin Blackmer. Inbound pass comes in to Michael Slezak. He'll give it up to Streetman all the way around. Dribbling forward is Josh Bryson. And they're going to call 3 seconds. That's going to go against Brennan, who's camped out in the middle of everything. A rare call these days, but they called it. Zach Jewell has it for F.A.I.T.H. They're up 23-2 with 7 minutes to go in the first half. Jewell kicks it out, triple teamed briefly. Colin Blackmer gives it up to his brother Grant. Now Gleason comes over. He drifts into the left corner. Dribbles out. Back up to Colin Blackmer. He'll run, jump. Kind of a wild shot off the backboard. No good. And Josh Bryson comes down with the rebound. Scott Streetman has it on the far side. Now Rowe comes into the corner, fakes a shot, looks at Streetman, and it's stolen by Jewell. Jewell will settle as everybody goes back. F.A.I.T.H. with the ball now after the turnover. Gleason gets it on this side. Colin Blackmer has it now. And Jewell just snuck by him. Nice give and go. An easy 2 points makes it 25-2 with 6 minutes to go in the second quarter. Scott Streetman dribbles across the timeline, now drifts over to his right side. Rose got it on the far side, give and go to Streetman. He'll put it up and he's going to line for two. And I think that foul's going against Irvin.
Yeah, I think so too.
Yep.
But that's only his first. There's only two fouls on the Falcons, four on the Lions.
Yeah, and in a game, and to be honest with you, in a game with this points gap, the refs are not going to call a lot of fouls. They're just not going to do it. First free throw is up and no good off the back of the rim by Streetman. Irvin will sit down. And Devin Kaufman back in the game. Second free throw is off the back of the rim. Same spot. Brennan had it momentarily but lost it. And Colin Blackmer comes up with it. And they'll settle. F.A.I.T.H. Falcons on offense now. Lions extend the defense.
Ooh.
And Brennan with the steal just stepped in and took it. Not a great pass that time.
No, you got to watch those passing lanes.
Paul Slezak in the game for Lake Orion, oh. And that's going to be a foul against Jewell.
That's his first.
Yep. Kind of a silly foul. The pass comes over to Josh Bryson. Brennan goes hard to the hole, just missed it, double teamed. Good athleticism, couldn't finish, but Lake Orion controls the ball. Streetman goes hard to the hole, jumps over Kaufman, puts it up and in. Scott Streetman with a nice move, sliding to his right. Good body control, makes it 25-4.
He's been their whole offense.
Yeah. Quickly ahead now underneath for an easy layup, and he missed it.
Missed the bunny.
That was Garrett Gleason, but the putback is good.
And that was Blackmer with the putback.
And Grant Blackmer with the putback. Under 5 minutes to go, first half, 27-4. Streetman drives in, kicks it out. Brendan's got it low post, ducks, little running hook shot, no good.
Sometimes you can be too open.
Controlled by F.A.I.T.H. Colin Blackmer will put up a three, put it up and in. 27-4, 4:28 to go, first half. Streetman will run it up on top. He's got Bryson to his left, drives to his right. Gets it back up after the toss in the corner. Brennan goes up to Slezak, Michael Slezak. Now Streetman has it up on top. Little ball fake, goes to the elbow. Gets it kicked back out. And he just lost the handle. Out of bounds, F.A.I.T.H. Falcons ball. Scott Hayes coming in for Colin Blackmer. I'm sorry, for Grant Blackmer. For
too
F.A.I.T.H.
many Blackmers.
There's too many Blackmers on the floor. Jewel drifts. He gets a pick from Kaufman. Give and go. Kaufman goes hard to the hole, making it look easy. 32-4 with 3:45 to go. Streetman will bring it down. Bryson drifts to his right. Now he cuts to his left. And we got a foul. I think it's another foul on Zach Jewell.
And a player control foul. Ran right into him. That's two on him.
Streetman nearly loses it on the inbounds pass. Gets a screen from Michael Slezak. Brennan goes up. Puts it up just a little too hard. Boy, he's getting some good looks. Nothing's dropping for Brennan tonight. Kaufman dribbles down left side, goes all the way into the paint on the low post, kicks it out to Nickel. Nickel for a long two. It's off the front of the rim, comes all the way back out to him, and the F.A.I.T.H. Falcons will settle. Gleason comes up and takes it up top. He's up at midcourt. Guarded by Michael Slezak. Dumps another give and go. That's going to be good. They're going to say, well, it depends on which official. They're going to say before the shot there was a push. And that's on Ian Brennan with a push before the shot.
Yeah, two on him.
Two on Brennan. Trying to get the ball in is Gleason. And Jewell just broke through and got an easy layup. Joel Shepard with the two, I should say.
Yeah.
Make sure you give that to Joel.
Yeah, I did.
Okay, good.
Those are the kind of things that make coach go nuts, you know, when somebody does that.
Well,
sneaks through.
It's somewhat of a function of fatigue. It right. really is. Mm-hmm. When you don't realize you're standing around until the other team's running past you, you know.
Yeah.
So exactly 3 minutes to go here in this first half.
And Coach Irvin's been good with his substitutions. Yep. He's kept everybody fresh. Yep.
Yeah, he could have kept his starters in and just kept the pedal down, but still, Lake Orion finds themselves down 34-4.
Yeah, a 30-point deficit's kind of a tough one.
Well, you got to keep your head in the game. I know it's hard. I've coached games like this, and it is hard to stay focused.
Yeah.
But there's still a lot of basketball to play.
Well, it looks like they're going to use a high-low post here.
Yep.
We're doing a 1-3-1.
You see how it shakes out. You got... Oh, we got a sub. Gleason's coming out. And Bryson Laster's coming in for Faith.
Yep, 1-3-1.
And a nice little turn and shoot by Michael Slezak. Missed it, though. Scott Streetman has it up on top. Comes across to Josh Bryson over here on the left side. Streetman goes into the corner, though. Good defense in his face. Streetman open for the three, but he missed everything. It's too long. Rebounded by Faith. They threw the ball away, and Streetman will collect it. Now he sees an opening, goes right to the hole, puts it up and in. Nice move as he drove around from the left side by Scott Streetman. Faith hurries down. Shepard, he's going to go right to the hole himself, put it up. Missed on a circus shot. Rebounded there by Scott Streetman. Has it tipped away by Shepard, and he's going to stop and settle the offense with 1:58 to go in the first half. 34-6, F.A.I.T.H. Falcons with the lead. They go down to Kaufman. He's going to drive hard to the hole. Dumps it underneath to Gleason. Now Nickel has it in the corner. He drives, kicks it out. Back out to Shepard, and they'll reset the offense with 1:35 to go here in the second quarter. Kaufman nearly has it stolen. Sees an opening. Dumps it to Gleason on the baseline. He missed a little bunny. And Scott Hayes, rather, with the attempt on the baseline.
And it went off with that.
It did. When it rains, it pours, right?
Oh, man.
Going to be F.A.I.T.H. Falcons ball out of bounds underneath. They've got the ball up on top. Laster had it for a minute. Now Nichols gets it. Shepard has it on the far side. Working it in the corner. Nichols is open on this side. They go on the low. Laster kicks it out to Nichols on top. Scott Kaufman on the high post, and he'll hit him. Took a step, but they didn't call it. Little ball fake. Going into the hole, and he got fouled. That's Brian Laster with the attempt, and he's going to shoot two. 1:02 to go.
Michael Slezak's foul.
Yes. 34-6. F.A.I.T.H. Falcons up on Lake Orion.
There you go.
Laster's first free throw is no good. Rushed it a little bit. And Kaufman's going to sit down, and Grant Blackmer's going to come in for the final minute of the first half. Second free throw is perfect, rattles in, rolls down. Makes it 35-6. Mason Rowe back in the game for Lake Orion. Dribbles across the timeline, goes in the corner to Michael Slezak. Streetman in the paint, puts it up and in. Another two for Scott Streetman. Now they're going to come with full court pressure. And Grant Blackmer gets it, and they break the press. Nickel open for three. He'll shoot and score. And that wasn't bad defense that time.
No.
Paul Slezak was right there.
Nickel just gets that ball and puts it up so quickly.
Unbelievable. They're going with the ball now. Mason Rowe has it in the corner. He puts it up and in for three. Makes it 38-11 with 14 seconds to go. Quickly ahead. Nickel from way downtown. College three puts it up and in. And that's going to be your first half score as Friedman tips it out of bounds. 41-11. That's your halftime score. F.A.I.T.H. Falcons over the Lake Orion Lions. We're going to send it back to Dave. We got an 8-minute halftime. We'll be back in about 6 minutes. And Dave's going to take care of you at halftime again. F.A.I.T.H. Falcons 41, Lake Orion Lions 11. You are listening to WMPC Sports.
It's boys high school basketball on Gospel 1230. Time now for the second half of the boys game tonight. We're going back to Hunters Creek Community Church. Greg Bolin and Bill Hetzler with all the play-by-play. Looks like it's going to be an early night, guys.
Yeah, it's 41-11. The F.A.I.T.H. Falcons are up. They got a 30-point lead, and that's playing quite a bit of their bench as well. So
yeah, yeah. There's been a lot of people in there. A lot of people have scored. They've got six, seven people that have scored in this game.
Yep. And it looks like they're going to leave some of the benchers in.
Mm-hmm.
And Lake Orion's going to start with their starters. It'll be F.A.I.T.H. Falcons ball to start out. Laster will take it out and get it in to Colin Blackmer. In that 2-1-2 zone defense, cutting to the hole is Gleason, and he walked. Dragged his foot.
Kind of dragged that pivot foot.
Yep.
And only one foot can move.
But that was Scott Hayes, I think, with the turnover. Yep. Want to give him due. Give him his due. Streetman has it on the far side. Now gives it up to Mason Rowe. Streetman with the long two, puts it up and in.
They just gave him a three.
They did. Well, I'm glad they did. And then there's a foul there, kind of a blocking foul on Michael Slezak. But they'll take it. They'll take the three.
They need the three.
41-14. Faster takes it out. Gets it in to Colin Blackmer. He gets a screen from Irvin. Kicks it back out to Grant. Now gets it back to Colin. He goes baseline, elevates, cross-court pass, nearly stolen. And then Grant has it in the corner on the right side. Grant's got it back on the baseline, and he kicks it out to Hayes. Hayes double team. Colin's got it baseline, kicks it up to Laster on the top. Just working the offense, being patient. Colin Blackmore has it up at the top of the key, goes in, dumps it off to his brother for an easy bank shot, a little five-footer. Makes it 43-14. 6:30 to go. Streetman has it over here on the right side. Back to Rowe in the corner. Streetman slides into the paint. Brendan scoops it up for him. Rowe with the long three puts it up and in. Makes it 43-17. Lake Orion with full court pressure. F.A.I.T.H. will break it. Grant Blackmer has it on the baseline. Back up to Laster. Going into the paint for a little teardrop shot is Colin Blackmer, 45-17. Rowe comes across the timeline with it. F.A.I.T.H. Falcons back in a 2-1-2. Rowe has it in the corner, puts it up, it's off the side of the rim. And we're back. Somebody stepped on our power cord out in the lobby. Sorry about that. The score is 45-17, 5:19 to go, third quarter. F.A.I.T.H. Falcons have the lead. Lake Orion has the ball. Streetmer has it up on top. And he'll take the shot in the corner. It's a little too long. He dove in trying to get the rebound, but Colin Blackmer took it away from him. He gets a pick from Scott Hayes. And now Laster has it on this side. Back up to Colin Blackmer. Grant's on the high post. They go cross court instead to Hayes. Working the offense patiently. Colin Blackmer into the paint. Gives it up to Grant on the top. He dribbles to his right. Gives it back to his brother. Low post to Irvin. He missed the easy shot. Got his own rebound. Went back door. Put it up and in and got fouled. Drake Irvin going to the line to shoot one. And that foul was on
Mason Rowe
underneath the point guard. He looks puzzled. Irvin's free throw is up and off the back of the rim. And he's going to get called for the foul. Kind of slapping at the ball. 47-17, 4:30 to go. Third quarter. Faith Falcons with the lead, Lions with the ball.
Faith's down a 2-1-2.
And looks like we've got a held ball on the floor. As Streetman hit the deck against Collin. And the arrow is in Lake Orion's favor. Ball comes in, Brennan has it in the corner, wants to go to the hole and does over Irvin. Has it tipped slightly and missed it. Grant Blackburn nearly double dribbled, he knows that. Held on to it. Swarming defense by Lake Orion now. Garrett Gleason in the game for Colin Blackmer. He's got the ball up on the top. Clock running under 4 minutes, third quarter. 30-point lead for the Faith Falcons. Grant Blackmer has the ball stripped as he's in the paint, scoops it up and kicks it out for Gleason. And we got a timeout.
Faith Falcons coach Irvin wants to talk with the guys.
No reason not to work the offense. You're always coaching, you're always teaching, no matter the situation,
that's
right?
That's right. In fact, even in a game when you're 30 points behind, it's still a good teachable moment. The coach can help his players to learn some things.
Well, the classic example from my career when I coached with my dad, in 91-92, the team was 2-14. Mm. The next year, we won the state championship.
There you go.
So you got to keep working. And some of the guys that won that state championship were on that 2-14 team.
I bet they felt good, didn't they?
Faith Falcons with the ball. Nearly got a 5 second count. Gleason has it at midcourt. Gets a pick from Lasker. Dumps it into Grant. Goes back door to Irvin. He puts it up. Got in a hurry and missed the easy layup, and Mason Rowe comes away with it for Lake Orion. Bryson has it on the far side, cutting up the Streetman. He'll take the shot just a little bit short. Irvin with the rebound for Faith. Gleason dribbles over now, and Hayes wasn't expecting it, but it ends up in Gleason's hands. He gives it to Irvin. His shot's too strong, and he just got another foul.
That's three on him now.
Yeah, he's reaching over the top and knocking guys down.
You can't do that.
Can't do that. But he's gotten two looks in a row with easy layups, and he just puts them up too strong. 47-17, 3 minutes to go, third quarter. Faith Falcons have the lead. Bryson's got the ball on the far side. Gets it to Brennan on the baseline. He misses a layup. And Grant Blackmer has the rebound. Gleason's got it up on top. Goes to Irvin on the low post. Tries a shovel pass. It's knocked out of bounds. Broken up by Bryson. It's going to be out of bounds to Faith underneath. Shepard coming back in the game. And Gleason's going to sit. Long pass out top. Streetman right there. Nearly stole it. Laster comes away with it, though, finally. Jewel dribbles over to his right. Gets it in the corner. Driving baseline, shot no good. And Streetman steals it from Jewel. He'll shoot the three. It's a little too long. Rebounded down there by Michael Kuzak.
Good job,
Brendan goes toward the hole, and he got fouled. Yeah. It's going to be out of bounds before the shot, though, I think. Yeah. Looks like Kaufman is set to come back in the game. He hasn't played yet this quarter. Going to come in for Lasker. Pass comes all the way up to the top and then thrown away. Rowe was trying to hit Bryson. Bryson was cutting in.
He zigged when he showed his leg.
That's how it worked. Jewell has it up at midcourt for the F.A.I.T.H. Falcons. 2:12 to go, third quarter, 47-17. Grant Blackmer has it now, gives it back to Jewell. He goes down low to Kaufman. He's double teamed and got hacked.
Not sure.
I don't know.
Two choices.
Grant Blackmer slides baseline, puts it up and in. Yeah, take your pick. We'll find out if anybody gets in foul trouble. The officials didn't really give us a clear sign. Bryson has it on the far side now for Lake Orion. Looks at Rowe in the corner. Streetman. Now on the right side, drives hard and got fouled on the baseline.
And that's Irvin, of course.
Just took it right to him. Out of bounds underneath for Lake Orion. Pass comes into Brennan. He puts it up off the back of the rim. 1:27 to go, third quarter, 49-17. F.A.I.T.H. Falcons with the ball and a big lead. Irvin goes low post. Dex Brennan misses a shot, misses a second shot. Brennan got clocked.
Yeah, I think his face is
got hit in the face and knocked down. And refs checking to make sure the floor's not wet, but there's a lot of contact there. There had to be a foul in there somewhere. Irvin turned around and he's just a little bit bigger than Brennan.
Yeah.
So it's going to be Lake Orion ball out of bounds.
No foul line, just a...
No. Just a series of unfortunate events. Streetman with the ball on the top now. Minute to go. Rowe with the long three. Falls short. Grant Blackmer got the rebound but had it tipped away by Bryson. Back to Streetman. And then he has it stolen by Jewell. Jewell comes down and he'll take a quick shot and he got fouled. And we'll see if it looks like it's going to give him three free throws.
Yeah.
Not exactly sure what the thinking was there for Zach Jewell though. With that quick shot. Didn't have a clear look at the ball and he shot it off balance.
Scott Streetman.
I think you're right.
Yeah, that's three on him.
One, two, three, four, five, six. Only get five. Lake Orion with some substitution confusion.
That makes it easy, right?
John Daniels in the game now for Lake Orion. First free throw is good from Zach Jewell. Second free throw, nice backspin, puts it in, gets the third. And now Garrett Gleason will come in for Grant Blackmer. Third free throw is off the back of the rim, going up high for it. There was Michael Slezak. 43 seconds to go, third quarter, 51-17. Lake Orion with the ball. Jewell tips it away, but Lake Orion controls it. And then Gleason knocked it out of bounds. Lake Orion ball on the far side. Pass comes in and stolen by Jewell. He pushes it ahead. Gleason now holds up wisely as the Lions hustle back on defense. 26 seconds to go. Jewell's got it on the far side. Gives it up to Gleason at midcourt. Dribbles to his right. Gets a pick from Irvin. Now he's going to bring it back out. Hits Kaufman on the top.
There he is, Scott
And it's going to be a foul on Bryson as Hayes was coming through. He hit the deck. Lake Orion ball underneath. Trying to get it into Irvin. Now they hit Hayes on the far side. Gives it up to Jewell. Kaufman's got it for a long three and rattles it in. 54-17. And that's going to be the third quarter score. The only one for the Lions that recognized what was going on was Ian Brennan, and they couldn't get him to throw the ball. He wanted to shoot from midcourt, but
they wouldn't give him the ball.
They weren't looking at the clock. So that's your third quarter score, 54-17. All Faith Falcons here in this third quarter. Let's talk about foul trouble, Bill.
Foul trouble. Well, Drake Irvin has four. He's the only one with foul trouble in the for the Falcons. And Scott Streetman has three, and he's the only one with foul trouble for the Lions. So one each.
Yeah, that's not too bad. And like I said, in a game like this that's not close, the officials, it's going to have to be a very obvious foul for them to call it, frankly.
Right. Like
moving,
a mugging.
Yeah, a moving pick or when someone hits the deck or, you know, a foul on a shot, that sort of thing. So.
Yeah, and if Scott Streetman does happen to foul out, he's been there. Basically, their offense.
Yeah.
Out of the 17 points, he's got 11 of them.
Yeah. So we're coming out set here for the fourth quarter. Faith Falcons ball to start out. Gleason will take it out and give it in to Jewell. He gets a pick. Gives it back up to Irvin, who's way out by the three-point line. Now they're going to run through some paces. Looks like they're running a rotation. Jewell dribbles in. Gives it up to Garrett Gleason. Shepard to Jewell. Jewell guarded by Streetman. Comes up high to Hayes on the top. Shepard's open for a three. It rattles down and no good. Rebounded, though, down there by Gleason. And the Faith Falcons will reset. Trying to sneak in the back door. Irvin comes away with it. Now they'll kick it back out. 50 seconds gone here in this third quarter. Sole possession by the Faith Falcons. Trying to sneak it in. And it's tipped away, but Shepard comes up with it and gives it to Jewell. He'll go baseline. Try the running J. Irvin collects it, puts it up and in. Drake Irvin with the make, 56-17, 6:51 to go in the game. Streetman dumps it in, and Irvin
there's
just
Irvin's fifth.
That's his fifth. He reached over. He looked shocked, but he had the inside position, and he reached over and tipped the ball away. That's a foul every time.
Oh yeah. There's no way they're not going to call that.
No. So Brian Laster will come in for him. And it looks like Colin Blackmer is going to come back in the game as well.
For Hayes,
right. Lake Orion ball underneath. And they get it up on top. Streetman has it on this side. Brennan turns, shoots just a little bit short. And he saved the ball in. Streetman goes for it, but it's tipped to Colin Blackmer. He goes ahead. Putting it up and in is Garrett Gleason. And that's good, and he's going to shoot one, the old-fashioned three. Not sure why the Faith Falcons are pushing the pace at this point.
They really need it.
And you'll notice now, Bill, with the point spread, there is a running clock.
Yeah.
Which is only appropriate. Yeah. Free throw is no good, and it's tipped out of bounds. That's going to be Lions ball. Brennan will take it out. And now he's going to go out of the game. And Hunter Creo in the game for Lake Orion. Streetman brings the ball down. Kicks it out. It's a long shot for three, and it's good. Nice job there by Michael Slezak. Makes it 58-20. And Faith will push it ahead. Now they'll settle in their offense. Hopefully their goal will be just speed of burn time.
And they're going to spread the floor.
Yep. Blackmore gets it to Gleason. And it's knocked out of bounds by Slezak over there. Faith Falcons ball on the side. Jewell has it, dribbles to his right. They kick it out, playing a little triangle on the right side. Now Colin Blackmer has it, goes cross court. They kick it back out to Gleason. Under 5 minutes to go in the contest, 58-20. Faith Falcons have the ball. Playing a little keep away, burning some clock, which I think is good sportsmanship. Jewell now will shoot the three, it's no good. Rebound to Streetman. Lions push it down. Streetman going into the paint, turns and shoots. It's off to the side, no good. Colin Blackmer with the rebound. He hustles down, and they kick it back out. And a long three from Brian Lasker, and he makes it 61-20. 4:20 to go.
And that was his first bucket.
And a long three is just a little bit too long there by Mason Rowe. But the Lions retain possession. Streetman has his pocket picked by Jewell. He wants to run. Now he'll wisely hold it up. Gleason's got it, goes into the paint, kicks it out to Jewell. He'll shoot a three from the corner. It's long. And it's going to be a foul on Michael Slezak as he reached over.
That's three on him.
Clock running at 3:37.
That's a bonus now for the Falcons.
Shepard at the line to shoot the 1-1. Clock running at 3:10, 61-20. First free throw rattles in and out. And nice rebound there by Hunter Crail. Paul Slezak also in the game. There's a shot on the far side, rebounded by Jewell. He'll settle it down, under 3 minutes to go. Faith Falcons in their half-court offense. Hayes thought about a three, Jewell thought about a three. Colin Blackmer hustles it in underneath, and we got a foul. That's going to be an easy layup by Joel Shepard, and he's going to shoot the free throw. Clock running at 2:30, 63-20. And Streetman's going to sit down and get some applause from the crowd.
Coach has emptied the bench.
Evan Chance in the game. Bradley Brown in the game for Lake Orion.
Jared Jenkins in the game.
Yep. First free throw is good. Clock running under 2 minutes. Shepard will sit down after that make. 64-20. Bradley Brown with the ball, dribbles off his foot, dives for it, nearly saved it. Good hustle by Brown, but he couldn't quite save it. And it'll be Faith Falcons ball out of bounds. Nichols back in the game. Basically sat the second half. Laster going hard to the hole, no good. Knocked out of bounds by Brown. It's going to be up. They're going to give it to Lake Orion. Coming down to a minute to go, 64-20 Faith Falcons. Brown will dribble down across the timeline. Looking for some help. And the pass goes out of bounds. Jared Jenkins couldn't handle that. It had some spice on it. He'll come up and challenge the ball, Will Jenkins. Playing hustling defense. Shot on the baseline, no good. Brown with the rebound. Norick with the rebound, rather, and dribbles all the way down into the paint. Pushes it ahead to Colin Blackmer, and he'll lay it up and in with 25 seconds to go. Now Norick has the ball. Dribbles across the timeline for Lake Orion. 15 seconds to go, and it's stolen. And Zach Jewell will bring it across the timeline, and that'll be your ball game, folks. They won't take another shot in this game. Well, what can you say, Bill? This was all F.A.I.T.H. Falcons tonight. The final score, 66-20, and the F.A.I.T.H. Falcons looked really strong tonight.
They did. They looked. They executed very well. I mean, you know, they had a few bunnies that they missed, but they executed well. Their defense was very strong, and they were quick on the floor. Quick, very quick.
Absolutely. Well, our girls' game was much better as far as listening, but we hope you enjoyed listening to the game, whether you were listening on your radio or on your smartphone or on your computer. We thank you for joining us tonight. Our final score here for the F.A.I.T.H. Falcons boys varsity is F.A.I.T.H. 66, Lake Orion Baptist Lions 20. You've been listening to a presentation of WMPC Sports. And on behalf of Bill Hatcher, I'm Greg Bullen. We'll see you next week for Lapeer High School girls varsity basketball.
Yes.
Back to you, Dave.